Do not adjust your TV. We are controlling the vertical. We are controlling the horizontal. We are controlling everything. Welcome to the Gorgeous George Show. And my name is Kay Lazar. I am your host. And here we go. C'est si bon! Bonjour, madame et messieurs. La vie en rose. Let's see. Les vins avantes dans il y a. Égalité, fraternité. Société. Fraternité. Liberté. And welcome. It was a rough week in France last week, and we are mindful of that. What I am afraid of is that we don't want what happened in France to happen. What happened in America after 9/11, where the saber rattlers got involved. And we don't want National Front and Le Pen to take over France, so let's keep the Patriot Act out of there, and let's not try to go into those places. I see France is already moving into Syria, which is what they should do. So anyway, France is our oldest ally, and France, it's because of Lafayette. We've never had a war with France. They supported the Union in the Civil War. And we drive on the right side of the road, thanks to France. We're the only English-speaking country in the world. So France is our oldest ally, and it's so. We're all in it with France. Oh, by the way, this is the Gorgeous George Show, and Gorgeous George is not here yet. Gorgeous George has been working very hard helping the poor, and in fact, he's been helping the poor a lot lately. His grandmother, his girlfriend, his kids. Oh, by the way, I had a kind of a rough time myself. My ex-girlfriend and her new husband have been honeymooning, and they went to Scotland, and they actually on their honeymoon, and they went to the Loch Ness, and they tried to go swimming there, and as soon as they got in the water, the monster got up and left. So anyway, I gotta tell you a funny story about France. Now that, since it's so serious over there. Groucho Marx in the mid-70s got the award in France, the Legion d'Honneur, and they had a big speech at the French Parliament, and a woman introduced him and spoke in English and said, "Listen, I know fluent French. You could just speak in French." So for the next 20 minutes, she started extolling the virtues of Groucho for the next 20 minutes in French, and then he said, "And now Groucho will speak a few words of French to us." And Groucho went to the microphone and said, "Voulez-vous vous asseoir avec moi?" Which actually caused such a sensation that it became a song from Lady Marmalade. So if you don't know any French, you certainly should know that the next time you're in Paris. Voulez-vous vous asseoir avec moi? It got a lot of GIs laid during at the end of the occupation in 1945. What else? Gorgeous George is coming your way. We're going to have a great night tonight. We have a week before Thanksgiving, so I hope you get your turkey and giblets and everything, and your stuffing and your mashed potatoes. We deal with a lot of political talk on this show and everything. We talk about last week we talked about the gay movement. There's also the transgender movement, the women's movement. The only movement we care about on this show is the bowel movement. So keep your pants off. Gorgeous George will be here shortly. So, without any further delay, I'm Kay Lazar, and welcome to the Gorgeous George Show.
Woo, baby, woo! How you doing? It is Gorgeous George in the house tonight. Show 5, we're going to actually go say show 4 because show 3 never got recorded. Show 3 never got recorded, so we're going to say show 5. I'm a little under the weather. I've been sneezing a little bit, doing my thing, a little sneezing, but the show must go on, so we continue the show. We got Thanksgiving coming up next week, a little bit of Thanksgiving. And, of course, we're not going to have any Christmas. You know, we usually do our Christmas stuff, but we're not going to be doing any Christmas. So, you know, we might throw in a little something-something tonight. But anyway, we're going to do some more music, and I got to do my songs I've done before. And I might be repetitious a little bit, but I don't care because it's my world, and we're going to do it. And let's go ahead and crank it. I'm a little bit under the weather tonight, so I might not be as good as I was week one, but we're going to do it anyway. Let's go. Let's go with the music here. Let's gig it. Let's make it happen. Let's do it now. Because you're making me want to talk, making me do some more ad lib here. And then, is it working, my friend? Is it working? Abracadabra, hocus pocus. Now, raise it up. What does it sound like? Sounds like it's sick. Is that it? Sounds a little. Sounds a little different. Doesn't sound like the normal. All right, let's go ahead to the Ronnie Millsap one then, because obviously that's trying to work itself up here. So we're gonna go to the Ronnie Millsap one, and there ain't no getting over me. Let's do it right now for all you ladies out there that crapped on me, shitted on me. No, let's do the. That's not what I want to do. I want to do the. That's not what I want to do. I saw Mama fingering Santa Claus one Christmas morning. I saw Mama fingering, and I saw Santa Claus fingering Mama under the mistletoe. All right. Let's raise it up. Ladies, tell you what time. Well, you can walk out on me tonight. If you think that it ain't feeling right, but darling, there ain't no getting over me. Well, you can say that you need to be free, but there ain't no place that I won't be. Sweet darling, there ain't no getting over me. I'll be the bill that you forgot to pay, and I'll be the dream that makes you cream in your pants. I'll be the song on the radio, and I'll be the reason that you tell the boys go to hell. Don't you know you can tell everyone that we're through, and you might even believe it too. But darling, there ain't no getting over Gigi. Sweet darling, there ain't no getting over Gigi. That's right. You can try and try and try, but there ain't no getting over me. You can go ahead and close the door and pretend like I never existed, but there is no getting over the Mac Daddy. The man that's causing this wonderment for all you ladies out there. I'll be the face that you see in the crowd, and I'll be the times that you cry out loud, and I'll be the smile when there's no one around. I'll be the book you just can't put down. Don't you know you can walk out on me tonight? And if you think that it ain't feeling right, but darling, there ain't no getting over me. You'll see, sweet darling, there ain't no getting over me. No, 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 darling. There ain't no getting over gorgeous touch. No, no. Sweet darling,
Oh, darling. Ooh, ooh. No, darling. There ain't no getting over your discharge. No, no. Oh, darling. There ain't no getting over me. You'll see. Because when I put you in place, you'll be no getting over GG. When I put you, strap you down and put you in place. And we'll go up like this.
Yes.
Woo! All right, what's next? Gorgeous George.
Well, I guess we're going to do a Christmas song. I mean, I'm not really feeling it. So, I mean,
I'll help you sing. This is a really good song.
You want me to sing
this
song here?
This is a good song. This is a song you should know.
It's a song I should know?
Yeah.
Deck the balls with Giles or Holly. La, 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 la. Okay.
You'll love this song.
Okay. Where does the Elvis here? All right. I don't need a lot of presents to make my Christmas bright. I just need my baby's arms around me tonight. Santa, hear my plea. Santa, bring me a baby back to me. The Christmas tree is ready. The candles all glow. But with baby far away, what good is a mistletoe? Santa, hear my plea. Santa, bring me some pussy to me. Please make the reindeer hurry. Well, the time is drawing near. Wanna spread them legs so I can put my baby in her rear. Hey, I want those pussy. I want to eat it good. Wanna put some sugar on top and make it tasty for me. Hear my plea. Santa, don't finger me. Please make these reindeer. Please make these reindeer hurry. Well, the time is drawing near. It won't seem me like Christmas unless my baby's right here. Fill my socks and candy. No bright and shiny toys. You want to make me happy? Let me fill your clip, miss, with some joy.
You have to just too tight. Heading down south to the land of the pines. I'm thumbing my way into North Carolina. Praying to Sarah in the road and pray to God. And there see headlights.
Headlights.
Made it down the coast in 17 hours. I'm picking me a bouquet of dogwood flowers. And I'm hoping that Raleigh can see my baby tonight.
Right here.
So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, till the cows come home. Rock me, mama, and I'll finger you too. Hey, let Gigi finger you.
All right, got who are you right here?
Riding on the cold up New England. I was born to be a fiddler in an old-time string band. My baby plays guitar. I play the banjo now. Oh, North County winners, keep engaging me again. I lost my money playing poker, so I had to leave town. And ain't turning back to living that old life no more. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, anytime you feel. Hey, mama, finger me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, finger me. Yeah, finger. Rock me hard. Rock me soft. And let's rock under the covers. Let's rock in the bed. Let's shake it up and down. Let's go 69 like the way I want to go. rock it real good and rock me all time. Rock it all way and sideways, because I'll rock it with you. This dude was 69 under the covers. Walking to the south out of Roanoke, I caught a trucker out of Philly, had a nice long toque. He's heading way down to the Cumberland Gap, to Johnson City, Tennessee. I gotta get move on before the sun. I hear my baby calling my name. I know that she's only the one, that if I died, at least we'll die free. Riley, that's right. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, like any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Oh, rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. Ooh, mama. Mama, rock me hard, and me rock you hard. Spread them legs, I got the cream cheese with the knife, so I can spread it over in your little vagina area. Rock me hard so I can rock you good. Let me spread the cream cheese on your vagina, so that I can go ahead and get a tasty, zesty treat.
Right on.
Okay.
He's ruined my song.
Too tight.
Darius Rucker, you mean Hootie?
Yes. My song.
Well, take that R off. What do you get? Put an F on there. What do you get?
Bob Dylan wrote this song.
I wrote it, man. Give me some room here.
There's barely enough room.
All right.
Hold on.
Because we don't have everything that I want, so that's the problem.
Oh, it's not lined up.
And I'm not really, I'm under the weather. I don't feel like I can do any Matchbox 20 right now.
Okay, well, here's a song you could do. You're going to love this one.
Now, what is this now?
It's called I Can Help.
No, I can't do that.
Well, I'll do it. Well, you just called in on me.
I know the song.
The song? We'll have a good time. Come on, sing it, brother. I don't even know this song.
You don't know this song.
Everyone knows this song.
It sounds like Ringo Starr. It sounds like Ringo Starr, but it's not.
Oh, yeah. Philly Swan.
Okay.
I'll take the lead. If you got a problem and you don't know what it is, you need a hand, I can assure you this, I can help. I got two strong arms, I can help. It would sure do me good to do you good, let me help. It's a fact that people get lonely, ain't nothing new. But a woman like you, baby, should never have the blues, let me help. I got two for me, I can help. It would sure do me good to do you good, let me help.
I can see my reflection on top of your skull.
Really? Getting there, right? When I go to sleep at night, you're always a part of my dreams.
I hope not, Kevin. That's pretty sick.
Holding me tight and telling me everything I want to hear. Don't forget me, baby. All you gotta do is call. You know how I feel about you. I can do anything at all. Let me help.
Let me help.
Let the child meet the daddy. I can help. It would sure do me good to do you good. Let me help.
Need some help?
I need plenty of help.
What help you need?
All right, here now I'm going to do a little dance now.
Oh,
everybody.
Well, do the dance, do the dance.
Yeah.
Do the dance.
I'm an Irish kid. Here we go. When I go to sleep at night, You're always a part of my dreams.
Okay. Sounds perverted, but okay. Sounds
holding me tight.
Sounds sick, actually.
And telling me everything I want to hear. Don't forget the baby. All you got to do is call. You know how I feel about you. If I could do anything at all, let me help. If your child needs a daddy, I can help. It would sure do me good to do you good. Let me help. All right. Everybody, I can help.
I can help.
Sound like Ringo Starr, but it's not.
Oh, yeah.
It sounds like Ringo Starr. Okay.
All right.
All right.
I can help!
All right. So now, other than the Matchbox 20, what else do we have?
And
other than that Christmas song.
Okay, we have Southern Nights.
No.
Let's all do that. That's our theme song here. You like The Wanderer?
No.
Well, then that's all we got.
Let me back off. I'm under the weather, so I'm gonna do the Matchbox 20 song.
Okay, do Matchbox 20.
I'm not doing the push. I'm doing the I'm not doing push.
Well, that's all I got.
No, you got the other one. If you're lonely,
I got that one.
If you're gone, okay. Now you see. Okay. Okay.
What's
now,
the one?
I'm gonna butcher this. I'm gonna butcher this, and I don't want to do that. I gotta be really on my A game here. I'm under the weather too, because I'm gonna.
If you're gone.
Okay. That was if you're gone, that's right.
Okay, that's the one you want. Okay.
All right, back up. Seriously.
Back up. I'm gonna catch whatever you catch.
Okay. This doesn't sound right here, but. I think you've already gone. I think you're already taken away. I'm finally scared now. You think I'm weak, and I think you're wrong. I think I've already lost you. Maybe feels like your hand is on the door. I thought this place was an empire, now I'm not relaxed, I can't be sure. I think you're so mean, I think we should try. I think I can need this in my life, and I think I'm just scared, thinking too much. I know I'm wrong, and that's a problem when you're gone. Baby, it's time to come home. There's an awful lot of breathing, but I can hardly move. Baby, if you're gone, baby, you need to come home. Come home. There's a whole lot of breathing and something and everything in you. I beg you here, I beg to hear your heart.
Yeah.
I bet the room just ain't the won't shine. I bet my hands I can stay here, and I bet you need more than you've mine. I think you're so mean, I think we should try. I think we can need, this is my life, and I think I'm just scared. That I know too much, and I can't relate, cause it's the problem that I'm feeling, cause you're gone. Baby, it's time to come home. There's an awful lot of breathing, but I can hardly move. And if you're gone, baby, you need to come home. Come home. There's a little bit of something in me, and everything in you.
It's a little different here.
I think we should try. I think we can need in my life. and I think I'm scared. I talk too much, and I know it's yes. What is wrong? And it's a problem, and I'm dealing if you're gone. Maybe it's time to come home. There's an awful lot of breathing, but I can hardly move. Baby, if you're gone, baby, you need to come home. Just come home. There's a little bit of something and everything in you. Everything in you. Everything in you. Everything in you.
I think I did okay, but I still butchered him. I did okay with it.
Great.
All right.
You did great,
right.
George. Let's.
All right. So anyway, let's go ahead and get the show started. We got. Okay. What's the other Christmas song?
We have the one more Christmas song, and
Christmas
all three
song.
Of us can sing it. Right. It's another Elvis song.
Is it Blue Balls?
No, it's a real
Blue
rocking
balls?
Song.
Blue Balls.
Yeah, I think that's what that is.
Blue Balls.
Blue Balls.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll have a blue.
Here we go.
Christmas.
Okay, no, it's not one.
Okay, you go and do that.
All right.
You do that right now. I'm going to get rid of this.
Okay.
Okay, this is a blue song.
To everybody in Richmond in advance, especially for George Sean.
All right. We got to sing this. Well, it's Christmas time, pretty baby. And the snow is falling on the ground. Well, it's Christmas time, pretty baby. And the snow is falling down. Well, you better be a real good little girl. Santa Claus is back in town.
You sing the next one.
All right.
Got no sleigh with the reindeer. No sack on my back. You gonna see me coming
in a big black Cadillac. Well, it's Christmas time, pretty baby, and the snow is falling on the ground.
Yellow.
Well, you're gonna be a real good little baby. Santa Claus is back in town. All right.
Well, Bob.
We're doing it. We're bringing a little blues to this. Put a little balls in there.
That's right. Yeah, that's right.
Put a little testosterone. You want to join in?
We got one judge. It's J.P. Morgan.
Get a piece of this, George.
Just kill that thing, man. I got an acapella here. Just kill that thing.
Right. Hey, okay.
I'll kill this crap.
Oh, yeah.
I got a little.
Here we go.
Hang up your pretty stockings and turn off that light. Santa's semen is coming down your chimney tonight. And it's Christmas time, pretty baby, and the snow is falling on the ground. Ask me how I know, cause I'm jerking a load. I'm jerking a load on the ground. And you better have your sucker in your mouth.
Santa Claus is back in town.
And he's coming through your chimney.
All right.
Hold on a second. All right. Back up.
Wait, you want to do that again?
Blue balls. I'll have a blue testicle without you. My balls will be in half and being segregated in two without you. My balls would be so blue, I would be known as Papa Smurf. And Papa Smurf would be so blue without parking his Cadillac in your vagina. It would be so percolating that I can park my Cadillac in that vagina. All right, I guess.
Are we going to do any more singing? Is that it?
All right,
is that it for the songs?
Let's get over here. Let's turn
the camera around.
Turn the table down. Turn the beat around. Yeah, okay. All right.
We had to do that for right. Simon Cowell.
Nah, I'm not worried about Simon Cowell because Simon Cowell doesn't sign my paychecks. You know, that's what it is. I sign everybody else's paychecks. All right. Anyway, what are you drinking, man? Is that urine or semen? What is
last
it?
Last time I saw a specimen like this, they shot the horse.
Okay. All right. All right, so this is the Gorgeous George Show, and we are November 18th, 2015. And like I said, this is our fifth show. We don't have six shows. We only have five shows. Now, of course, the week three, we did a show week three, but you might as well say it never will be aired because week three was never recorded. Week three was never recorded, so we're working upon the powers that be to get another show. We'll get another show hopefully here soon. All right, so that's okay, because like Gloria Gaynor once said, I never can say goodbye. I never can say goodbye, what Gloria Gaynor said. So that's what we're going to do. We're never going to say goodbye. This is our 21st season. We've been doing it good. 21st season. We've had virtually no guests, but we don't need guests. We've had no guests, but we don't need guests. All you need to do, ladies, is watch everything that comes out of my mouth. Watch me enunciate. Watch me enunciate. And pronunciate. And when I pronunciate, then you just put your hand and strum a little tune. You put your fingers down there and you strum a little tune. It might be Whistling Dixie down there. When you see me, you'll be queeving. You'll be having a conniption. And you'll be wondering, Gigi, would you help me play my banjo? Gigi, will you help me strum my organ? And I would be more than delighted to strum your organ, but you got to do it in harmony with me, and you got to do it in unison with me. That's right. All right. Now, we've got a lot to do, and we got a lot going on. We've been on this channel for a long-ass time. You know what I'm saying? And things happen, and I'm not going to get too much in detail. I'm going to talk in code. I don't need to get into detail as Morse code. And I'm going to talk in code here. Life is a revolving door. People come in your life and people go out your life. And please don't tell me I see 5 minutes. Ain't no way it was just fucking.
No, what time do we have? Just getting the signs together.
What time do we have? Okay, we're good?
Yeah,
okay.
We're good.
Got 6 minutes.
We got 2 hours. People's it's like a revolving door. This year has been a rocky year, and we lost a few good people. I do want to say this because we have neglected to talk about this, and I want to talk about this. Our buddy Bo, and we're not going to get into too much detail about it. Is in at MCV Hospital, and we are saying our prayers for him. He had a situation that happened. I can't get into detail. But Bo is in the hospital, and we hope for a speedy recovery for you. He's been in there for about a month, MCV. So we're hoping things work out. Yeah, Bo, you're watching. And Bo, we appreciate it, and we hope you're doing fine, Bo. And Bo, we all hope that you get better. So.
And if you don't know who we're talking about, Bo is the guy that comes here, he does the little rap and everything, and he's a very funny guy, and we're hoping
Get better.
Back on the show.
And by the way, we're hoping that things will work out for you, and you get better, and you get your mobility back. So that's what we're hoping. This year has been a very, trying year. It's been a very trying year for the most part. I'm not going to get into much detail. I have been in, what were you doing?
You said you're not going to go into detail.
Okay. Are you getting it? Okay. All right. So you're covering your ears. Okay. Covering your ears. Are there like bunny ears or what you got?
Oh, I don't know.
Bunny ears. Or you put some cotton in your ears or whatever. 8 months of 8 months of good times. 8 months of feeling like there's some good times that were had, and then having 8 months of good times being taken away from you. Mm. 8 months of being able to do things. 8 months to be in the company of a nice young lady. Ooh. A nice young lady in 8 months. Of course, people argue. People argue like cats and dogs. People will argue all the time like cats and dogs. But 8 months, and then 8 months pretty much disappears.
And I'm sitting here, like, wondering, you know, doing my thing over one of the, you know, I'm doing my thing, and I'm wondering what could have been. 8 months of good times. 8 months of good, you know, good quality time that we've had together, and then the, you know, the cradle falls down, the boat comes apart, the Titanic sinks. And, but you know what? I'm Gorgeous George. I'm a rock star. I've been doing this show for 21 years. So when I need to look at myself in the mirror and see who am I? What have I done? I am Gorgeous George. I'm the rock star. I've been doing what I've been doing for 21 years. And that says pretty much everything you need to know. So I am a fighter. I get by. I'm a fighter. I do what I want. I do as I feel to do. I'm very passionate upon everything. Things happen, but it's okay because things have a way of working themselves out.
Yep.
No matter what you do in life and what you do, and of course we talked about this before, you can be everything you want to be and more. When something goes awry, you make it right and you make it what you need to make it. The situation will probably work itself out. Probably this person will wake up. Hopefully this person will wake up and see it to be for what it is. See the reality. See the magnificent one. See the one that's causing everything in the wonderment. The magnificent one, the man that's causing this wonderment for all. And it takes no rocket scientist to figure out who that is. It is Gorgeous George. Gorgeous George is the man that's causing all of this. And it's causing everything. This show, causing the people to watch and causing everything to be what it is. Rights, I produce this show. I am the creator. And that's what I do. So I have a legacy. I have a legacy. I have what I have. And I'm pretty damn proud in what I do. I'm pretty proud in who I am and what I have. And I have people out there that enjoy what we do. Pretty much people that enjoy what we do. So we don't need negativity. We want positivity, positively. Mm. The only negativity that we want is HIV negativity. And Charlie Sheen, we feel really, really bad for you. But when you put your ding dong in too many holes, you never know what to expect. So probably. Charlie Sheen,
yep.
When you put your ding dong in places mm-hmm. where you can catch chlamydia,
yep.
catch chlamydia or catch a little bouquet of flowers, a floral arrangement of STD florist,
yes,
you can expect to pretty much expect the worst.
I made a movie with Charlie Sheen once years ago, The Shadow Conspiracy, Made in Richmond. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Very nice. Yeah. Also, like you said, you're gorgeous. This is Gorgeous Friggin' George.
That's right.
As we don't call him Friggin' George. In fact, I knew him as Friggin' George so much. I thought that was his first name. Is this Friggin' George? Where's that Friggin' George?
There's a CNC and the Toys R Us.
Yeah.
And then there's a midget of you when you pull his finger. And you know what that midget says?
What?
Take a midget of you. Take a good guess and gander what that thing says.
What does it say?
Hey, pal. Watch me talk, pal. That's right.
Well,
that's right. Also, hey, pal. And you pull a string. You pull a string, and it's everything it says is, hey, pal, what do you think? Hey, pal, I'm a dwarf. I'm a midget, but hey, it's okay. Hey, pal. Hey, pal, put the ever-ready battery cells in my packet. Hey, pal, don't put your finger down there. Don't finger me down there.
Hey.
Oh man, you're hot tonight. Yeah. Now
what's that?
Now this person you're talking about is your boss, your employer.
It is.
It's about Charlie Sheen.
Yes, Charlie Sheen.
That's who he's talking about.
I know. We don't talk, but we talk. We're talking. You mean Charlie Sheen? Yeah, Charlie? He's HIV positive. We want to be positive, but not HIV positive.
That's the wrong kind of positive.
That's a bouquet of STD flowers from the florist, arrangement.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the florist arrangement. You know, you never know when you can put it in there and come up with something like that.
Yeah. So, it's been a rough year.
Who would have thunked it?
Charlie Sheen,
yes.
Caitlyn Jenner.
Yeah.
As you know.
I don't know what that is.
You know, she was on the cover of like Glamour magazine, Woman of the Year. I mean, I'm not kidding you. They actually made her Woman of the Year.
Yeah.
I have to admit, nobody worked harder to be a woman than her.
Right.
That's something I would never.
I don't know. I don't know. I mean, what about Dennis Rodman?
Dennis Rodman. That would actually help his image. Cavorting around with the North Koreans.
Yeah. The enemy. I mean, what about Dennis Rodman putting on the drag? You know, he wanted to be special, and then
of course halfway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dennis Rodman, and then you got RuPaul. I mean, you know.
Yeah, RuPaul.
RuPaul, you know.
Well, these guys are still men, though.
Yeah.
Are they?
They're not changing their.
Are they? How do you know? How do you know that?
Who they are?
RuPaul. I mean, I think RuPaul's sliced and diced.
RuPaul. You know, RuPaul's a better slice and dice than a man. I figured it
out. Who? Then who?
RuPaul's a better looking woman than a man.
Yeah.
Well,
I don't know.
I mean, he's not that
pretty damn scary, huh?
Yeah.
Adam's apple. Long, Adam's
I didn't
apple.
Even expect a
long fingernails, Adam's apple, and a pretty much a freaking jowl and a big face, you know.
Well, let me tell you something. Our audience is basically 14-year-old men. So,
Gavin, you have not studied the statistics. We are picking up more women now.
Oh, finally.
Now, we have. We're picking up more women where they strum themselves down there and they watch us.
Yeah. Well, let me tell you
something. When they watch us, they strum themselves. Hey, we got some more things to do, so make it fast because I got some Craigslist ads to read, too.
Oh, okay. Wow. Well, I think because we're men, I think a man doesn't have to be as good looking as you think. A woman, unfortunately, in today's society, you expect like Carla Fiorina, brilliant woman, but of course, Mr. Trump has to make fun of her because of how she looks.
While
none of those, she's
face.
A better looking woman than most of those men are as men.
She looks like a freaking man. She looks like a freaking man, and she's a prune face.
All right. Caitlyn Jenner, basically, she should watch out for the next target because Charlie Sheen's going to come after you. Yeah. Just be careful, Caitlyn Jenner.
Right. If you're HIV positive, I mean, who do you date after that? I mean, there's nobody wants you.
Yeah.
I mean, who the hell wants to die?
Exactly.
You just slide it in. You know, like I said, you know, the two priests were wondering what killed Sister Mary. And it was a paper machete. And they put their heads together, and they were putting their heads together, and they formulated the weapon that killed Sister Mary. And it's a piece of paper. You fold their dropes, their cloth together, and their heads are formed of a penis. And they go ahead and that, you know, take the piece of paper, and there you go. They become, you know, they become a penis. Their heads together form a shape of a penis. And the penis did kill Sister Mary.
What?
The penis killed Sister Mary.
But the penis is mightier than the sword?
The penis is
mightier
than the sword?
The pen is mightier.
The penis killed Sister Mary. That's all I'm saying.
No. That says pen is.
The pen is mightier than the sword. I read it.
Anyway, one day the little boy was wondering, you know, was tossing and turning in bed and said, Daddy, I got all these thoughts of sex and I want you to tell me all about how to put it and how to do it and how to stick it in and how to stick it out, you know? I said, because I was listening to that song by Clarence Carter about stroking. I stroke it to the east. I stroke it to the west. I almost stroked it inside of a beehive. But Daddy, tell me. I almost stroked it in the beehive, but I was worried about those bees. Tell me about the birds and the bees and the sex. Because I had all this sex education in class, and I was wondering what was up. Well, son, it's like this. You see this right here? This is what you call the Cadillac. This is the Cadillac. You see there? And you see that your mom's front compartment right there? That's what we call the garage. And every now and then, when your daddy gets a little bit frisky, and your mom loves it, dad gets a little frisky, you know what he does? He parks his car in your mom's frontal compartment, better known as the garage. Okay, Daddy, now I understand. Now you understand there, son? Yeah, Daddy, I understand. All right, now, go to sleep. So a few hours later, all right, seriously, now you need to get out of this bed because now it's time for me to park my Continental, my Cadillac, and your Continental Cadillac in your mom's garage. I got to park it in your mom's garage right now. Daddy, I'm so sorry, but my little red Volkswagen is already in there.
Oh, God. I remember a story like that when I was a kid where it said, what's that?
My little red Volkswagen, Daddy, is already in there.
The mother says, "That's my gate," and the father says, "That's my V8." And hey, turn on your headlights, open your gate, here comes
and
Danny.
The moral with of the story is incensed and incest is the way of the world. Incense and incest is the way of the world.
I'm incensed at that incest.
Okay.
I'm incensed.
Okay. All right.
I'm intrigued.
Now, what about Craigslist?
What's the deal with that mess?
We just have some stuff that I was looking. You go to Craigslist and you see these crazy ads. And
crazy
ads, and we don't have the list running from me. Actually, if we had the Wi-Fi in here with the computer,
yeah,
we'd be able to pull them up here. But this one is a few things off the top of my head that I remember.
This is an upgraded show.
And this lady says, I am looking for a bowl of fruit. Mm. You be the banana, I be the kumquat. You take the banana and the kumquat, and we can put some cherries and some grapes and wrap it around the two bowls of fruit. You be the banana, you be the... I'll be the kumquat, and you be the banana. I'll be the grapefruit, and we can put it around. I'm looking for some fruit and mm-hmm. some sex. Fruit and sex is what I'm looking for. Make it snappy. Let's do it now. And I'm looking at that. Okay. As this is called, this is the casual encounters.
Yeah. This is the number one show on cable access. The show.
Casual encounters.
I'm happy, George, that you're wearing the New York Giants color today of royal.
First
blue.
Of all, this is the Dallas Cowboy color.
And, are you sure?
And I'm actually dressed in Dallas Cowboy colors. I'm
this
wearing
is the Dallas
blue
Cowboy
and gray.
Blue. Dallas Cowboy color is blue. Okay.
And so now, hold on, we
got some more, but go ahead and
well,
interrupt
anyway,
me. Interrupt
I'm
me
dressed
like you were
in, and just like the Dallas Cowboys, dressed in Union blue and Confederate gray. I'm dressed like a piece on the Civil War chess set. It's really cool.
Where's the gray? Oh, the gray. Okay. It's the gray. Okay. So then, you know, I guess other casual counters and say, you know, it's time for a head of lettuce. You bring the head of lettuce and we can have a party. I want 420. I'll use some 420 and we'll smoke. You smoke and we'll screw and we'll smoke. Bring the bowl. And,
wow.
You know, and let's have some fun. And so, therefore, you know, some leaves the names. They leave the name and leave the telephone number. So, you know, I actually called this lady up here.
Okay.
Fine.
And I asked her. I said, now, you were talking about bringing the bowl. What kind of bowl you want? You want a bowl of cereal? What kind of bowl do you want me to bring? She said, man, you're whacked, man. You know what I mean. I said, well, I don't know what you mean. I said, you want 420. So you want to do it at 420? Is that what you want to do? You want to have this date at 420? She said, man, you're wickety, wickety, wickety whacked. 420. You know what 420 is? I said, well, that's the time on my watch is 420. He said, no. You say, no. You need some smoke. Have some smokes and smoking a pancake and a head of lettuce. Make sure you bring that head of lettuce, so I said, okay, so I said, in essence, you want to smoke. So, and actually, the 420 is the marijuanza.
Mm-hmm.
420 is the marijuanza, of course. I don't know if you knew that. The ganja and all that. So she wants to do the Janus and the marijuanza and smoke some.
Yeah.
And after that, she wants to have some sex.
Hmm.
She all, you know, so like I said, you know, have some sex, you know, eight ball center pocket. I said, now I will bring the right tool. Do you need an extension or do you want the right tool? Because I'm about ready to put the eight ball in the center pocket. Mm. And she's like telling me, she said, well, just strap it on and strap it in me because I want to be strapped. I said, okay, we'll do that. So anyway, but I never called her back because I was not down for the 420.
Oh,
I don't like the smell of 420. You know what I'm talking about?
Yep.
I know what you're talking about.
I mean, you're talking about the 420. I'm not like it down with the smell of 420.
Chances are Willie Nelson would have showed up. You don't want that.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Unless he's singing.
And then you have, hey, we're a married couple. My woman, I want to see my woman get banged upside down. I want to watch it and I want to film it. If you're the man that can do it to my woman, then I might hop in and participate. Now, wait. Now, hold the phone a second. Now, wait a second. You want to hop in and participate? You know, like Tone Loc once said, ain't no plans the man. Ain't no plans. Sheena was a man, ain't no plans the man. Mm. So, you know, he says, I might just hop in if you're doing it good to my woman and you bang her good. Nah, I don't think so. Because, like I said, this ain't romper room. And this ain't you know,
no funny
seeing the blazers, you know, or you know, sniff between the lines or sniffing, you know, scratch and sniff. That ain't gonna happen.
Yeah.
No funny business.
So Kevin, I mean, what do you think? If you got a response like that, would you show up or what would you
do? No, I would not. Listen, three's a crowd.
Yes.
I don't want to be anywhere where there's a third person.
Wait, three's company.
No, you're thinking of the TV show.
Three's Company. Is that what it is? Oh, I never saw Three's a Crowd.
No, Three's a Crowd. Okay, Three's a Crowd. Three people, I'm not talking just about sex. I'm talking about in any situation. Three people together. Three people on a bus. One person has to sit by themselves.
Okay.
Yep. Three people on an amusement park. One person has to ride the roller coaster with somebody else.
Three people
never work.
No, three people does work. I'm going to tell you why. Because you got the head. Okay. So the person's head, and then the person's bottom part, and then the person's other orifice. So actually you have three orifices in the body. So there's three different people. Well, now I guess you would need four people because
now
one person.
You need four. You need an even number.
Yeah, because one person.
In every situation.
Hold on. One person would be laid up. Unless you're like that monkey and you can just take care of your own private area and then have your be ate out on the backside from somebody else. So have somebody eat you out on the backside. Yeah, monkey was pleasuring.
It's like the fourth week in a row we've talked about
monkeys. No, I'm just saying.
Have you been at the zoo a lot lately? Hey, on your mind?
I'm saying if the monkey can pleasure himself, then, you know, I mean.
That's all they do.
That's half the battle.
Yeah.
That's half the battle, isn't it?
And fling crap.
Let me tell you something about monkey, or chimps, I should say. Mm-hmm. Is that look at them, look at us. Look at them, look at us. They didn't evolve, we did.
Right. Kevin, look, listen. If you could do that to yourself, if any of us could do that to ourselves, that's half the battle. If we could do that to ourselves, then we've reached nirvana. We've reached the plateau of nirvana. I mean, we don't need – you can do that to yourself. You don't need anybody.
I don't believe it or not, doing it to yourself is a little overrated.
Is that right?
It's always better just even to have dinner with a woman.
So you figure three people. So one is on the ground. Well, no, because there's three orifices too. Yeah, so I guess you got the mouth, and then the front orifice and the back orifice. But of course, then again, nothing anal. I mean, there's nothing that we do anal. I don't do anything anal. So I guess I don't do anything anal. So I guess three people would serve its purpose because you got one person on the ground, one person, you know, pretty much doing the oral from the front, and then the other person doing the oral giving head.
Yeah,
giving a head, giving a BJ. So three people. So three is company.
Is this the educational channel?
Yeah.
I'm learning these things.
I'm saying.
I live a very sheltered
three's
life.
Company.
Well.
On that incident.
Well, for one thing, okay, three's company. That means two people of the same gender will have to be there at least two people, maybe all three.
Well, now, you know? Okay, now.
So what I'm trying to say is that one of the people that's in the majority, that one of the two is going to be out left out.
Okay. Yeah.
And you never want to be the guy left out.
Then that's when you have a man, woman, and an animal. I have a monkey.
Well, wait a minute. The way you're talking.
You have a man, woman, and a monkey, and you're good to go. You have all the species you want. Mm. All the species you want, you know? Or maybe.
You're raised on a farm or something.
I'm just saying, you know. I
know a lot of farm boys.
Yeah, yeah.
they have the pretty similar stories.
But now, here's another one.
You have to do with sheep.
Here's another one. Oh, the sheep go, play with the sheep, Simon says. The CNC, the sheep goes, bleh. The sheep goes, bleh, when it's got something going on down its bottom fide up its orifice. The sheep goes, bleh, bleh, Simon CNC.
Wow.
But now, of course, there's all kinds of, but now imagine what the aliens do. Now have alien
from
sex.
Mexico?
No. Well, in Roswell too. You know what they did in Roswell?
New Mexico,
because you know about Roswell. They take the person's mind and they probe the person's mind, and then they become an alien. So they probe the person's mind, and then they become an alien. So then you have alien sex being up to, you know. So, you know, just imagine this little thing going out, you know, is walking around here like E.T. or some kind of freaking like E.T. and saying, pull my finger, E.T. phone home, ET phone home. So, you know, anyway, so then you see that finger.
You don't want to pull ET's finger, trust me.
That finger is, you know, it's gold, you know. So then he goes ahead and then he takes his thing, and then, of course, it's a woman.
Is ET?
2 minutes.
Is
2 minutes. We're just getting good here. We only got 2 minutes.
Yeah.
We got to wrap it up.
We don't
have 2 minutes?
We don't have to tell Richmond everything.
Professor, professor of sexology. Gorgeous. Yeah.
We got 2 minutes.
Yep.
We're just getting off into topic here about,
you know.
You
know, the end of Saturday Night Live where for 5 minutes they just talk, just stand.
All right, well, anyway.
That's basically
we're going to do more radio shows. We got a radio show. Hey, guys. Radio show December the 2nd.
Oh,
at WCLM Radio. How about it?
No.
I'll be there.
Huh?
Nope.
I'll
no?
be there.
No.
Yeah?
No.
Yeah?
Well, December 2nd. I don't know what I'm doing that
December
day.
December the 2nd, we're going to do a radio show at WCLM Radio.
All right.
Why not here?
You going to be here?
Maybe.
You going to be here. That's right. All right. So anyway, I don't know. But like I said, we're just getting good. We're talking about some things, and then my whole train of thought goes out the window. Anyway, there's one Mona Lisa. There's one Leaning Tower of Pisa. There's only one Gorgeous George. We only have 1 minute?
Well, I mean,
believe it or not, diamonds are forever, and so is Gorgeous George. I am what is causing all this. I am the wonderment of all. Don't hate me because I'm beautiful. I am the most beautiful thing that you could ever imagine. And I wish we could, you know, do more, but we just got cut off of, you know, this show went too fast.
You rule a lens.
This show went too fast.
It's not actually not long
bye-bye.
Enough.
Bye-bye. Next season. Bye.